Let's see here. Hello, hello, hello. Ha! You're golden at least that way. I just remembered something. Mute the phone. Haha. Okay. So, howdy folks, and welcome back to the Flying T-Bar Seat. It is Modern Monday, and we are diving into a whole new adventure. Last week, we managed to finally kill Chaos. And this week, we are going to dive into a series that I will maybe play more games of. I have access to some of them, so they would potentially be on the table. But we are playing Tales of Arise today. And I won't lie, before I started streaming, I had started this game. But then I got to thinking about it, I was like, you know what? This would be a good game for me to stream. So, I made it through Strangers of Paradise because I got that specifically to stream. And now we're moving on to this one because, again, I thought it was going to be a good idea. And hopefully, I'm right. There we go. Okay. Everything looks like it's working correctly. Oh, whoops. Okay, so we are actually, well, number one, just because I haven't actually, like, checked out some stuff in a long time. Okay, so it looks like it's just the SAO stuff. We will go ahead and we shall do new game. Input queuing time, adjust queuing time for buttons when launching attack combos. Map orientation fixed. Yes. Yes to all that. We do want subtitles. We will potentially, I don't know, we'll check out other stuff later. Like the camera controls. Pretty sure I went default. Now I will
In ages long past, it was believed that Mother Dana was indestructible and everlasting. Rena, on the other hand, was thought to be the domain of the gods, a paradise where the souls of the departed could rest forevermore. Oh, how wrong we were. In the face of Rena's unimaginable technology, its soldiers, clad in huge, shining armor, and its fearsome beasts, known as Zugals, the prosperity and bounty of Dana all but disappeared overnight. That was 300 years ago. The world of Dana fell under Renan rule, and its new masters split the land into five distinct realms. the Renin's five realms. It is ruled over by the tyrant Balzan, lord of the Firemaster Corps. Unrelenting fire scorches this barren wasteland. Dust storms course over the rocks and crags, and no relief is to be found from the oppressive heat. The Danann people toil as slaves. Day after day they suffer, under the ruthless oppression of the Renin soldiers, with only one hope of escape. Death. Only in death is their agony finally brought to an end. They have forgotten what it means to be free. So complete is the Renin's domination.
I think I might need to turn that down just a little bit. Let's try it. Okay.
Hurry up!
There we go. That's
pushing?
Not too
Put
bad.
Put the back into it, embedded.
Things in this game are
depressing. Thank you, Iron Mask.
That's okay, Cole. Are you hurt?
No, I'm fine. Iron Mask, you're bleeding. We need to get you looked at by Doc.
That bad, huh? Better safe than sorry, I suppose.
No murdering embedded. I'm so sorry, Iron Mask. You got hurt because of me. Don't sweat it, kid. It's not like I felt anything. But that's why Doc tells you to be extra careful, doesn't he? Yeah, but at the end of the day, I chose to stick my neck out for you and I don't regret a thing. Don't sweat it, Cole. Okay? Okay, thanks, Iron Mask. You'd probably be right about that. Okay.
You again. Sorry to trouble you, Doc. Look after yourself, and there'd be no need for sorries, would there? Now sit. So, still unable to remember anything, I take it?
Blank as always. Nothing but that strange dream.
No face, no memories. Unable to feel pain, you're only too eager to take on everybody else's. What will we do with you? Here, let me see. You may not be able to feel pain, but... But that doesn't mean you can't be wounded, just like everyone else. If you're not more careful, you'll wind up dead without even realizing it one of these days.
I watched another slave die today. More corpses than I care to count.
Unfortunately, that's hardly a rare sight around these parts.
Dannons are always dying, and the Rennens just watch. How long can this continue? Why doesn't anyone stand and fight? Keep your voice down, will you?
If only it was so simple, my friend. There have certainly been uprisings, all right. 3 centuries worth of the damn things. As for all the good they've done, take a look around and judge for yourself. There. That should just about do it. Now, do me a favor and try to stay out of trouble so the wound doesn't open again.
Doc, back when I knew nothing, you were the one who taught me just how things work around here. You know I'll always be grateful for that. But I can't just...
The race is won by the calm and the steady. You're still young, and you have time. Wait for the right moment, both for yourself and the world.
Wise words. Very wise words.
We'll be wrapping up for the day soon enough. Don't sit around here. Go out and feel the breeze against your skin. Even a slave's entitled to that. Just do me a favor and keep a low profile, all right? You stand out enough in that mask as it is.
Guess I'll go back to my room.
Are you okay? Thanks for saving me earlier. Can't go that way. Brad, I stick these weird stones on our bodies and work us to the bone until we're dead. As if the routine beatings from them weren't enough, when they're in a really bad mood, they stick their zoogles on us. Time to cause too much trouble out there. You already stand out plenty as it is wearing that mask of yours.
I'm a slave, just like everyone else here. So how come...
What are you looking at? You looking to get your ass kicked too?
I don't have a spirit core. Or face, or memories for that matter. Not worrying about it'll change anything.
I did forget that. I forgot he doesn't have a core. They're not moving. Damn it. God, this game is so dark right off the bat. Every last one of you embedded will die, and then we can do whatever we want with you. Now burn! Fuck you! So, no matter how tired you get of seeing them, you can always find Rena and Lanagus hanging up in the sky. I hate it. It's like they're watching over us, keeping an eye on our every move. The Lanagus especially is something else. There's no way we could ever hope to beat the Rennens when they can build floating castles like that. Ever wonder what those bright eyes like to burn all over the place? I'll tell you, it's the fuel they make us mine for. There's no reason for us to do it. Once we do, they just take it and light it up. And that's why it's hotter than hell here. Listen, whatever the bastards do to you, don't even think about trying to fight back against the Bright Eyes. Got it? I know. Not like any of us have a chance in hell of ever beating one of those soldiers or the Zoogles, let alone Lord Balsif. Shh, don't talk about this in public, you two. Who knows what they'll do if they hear you guys.
I should get some rest.
Rest?
I wonder how many people have slept in this bed before me. Mine for now, but for how long?
Tomorrow's another day. I guess I should get some shut-eye.
Yep, shut-eye is good.
I better head to work.
Time to go to work.
Freight train today, huh? Great.
I can jump! I am free! The ground does not hold me!
Great. Time to start another day toiling away from the lands. I'm not gonna do this until the day I die.
Look lively, slave! Let's see some work around here!
Grenar!
Zephyr, she's here.
Bitches be crazy.
The girl's nowhere to be found.
Silence.
Hey, Felix, did you find anything?
Not yet, sir. What do they expect from us on such short notice?
Hey, you're...
Oh yeah, our boy Iron Mask, he's a badass.
Idiots.
Sonic explosion.
You all missed your chance to become Lord, which means you lot live and die for me, the mighty Balthazar. Dub that through your skulls. Now hurry up and bring me Shion.
Yes, sir.
Even the drink's lost its appeal.
Someone's in a bad mood. Lord of Wolsey, ruler of Orbis Calagmia. Ah, but it's wild beast you prefer, isn't it? Do forgive me.
Ganabel Valkyris, what do you want?
From what I hear, you seem to be having some trouble over there in Calagmia. As a fellow lord, I merely thought to ask whether I could be of any assistance to you.
Enough with the false pretense. I can tell a rat when he's sniffing around.
Forgive me. I can only imagine the emotional toll failing to ascend the throne not once but twice must take. A most distressing state of affairs.
Shut up! It's none of your concern.
The crown contest is proceeding apace, and so quickly, I must say. It won't be long before the victor is crowned as the new sovereign.
I look forward to it, and you can be sure I won't forget our little chat.
Nor will I. Until next time.
You awake?
Who are you?
The name's Tilsa. I'm the medical officer for the Crimson Crows. You're in one of our safe houses.
Crimson Crows?
Don't tell me you've never heard of us. We're the resistance for the Danon people. We get in the way of the Bright Eyes' best laid plans.
The Danon resistance? I didn't know such a thing existed.
Oh, we exist all right. Though I guess we're not as famous as I thought we were. Seems like I know more about you than the other way around, Mr. Iron Mask. Is it true you can't take that thing off?
Yeah. Worse is that I don't even know why I'm wearing it. That woman I was with.
Oh, yeah. She's quite the character, isn't she? Zephyr should be interrogating her over in the slammer as we speak.
You locked her up? Why?
Why? Go take a look for yourself if you're so interested.
They're interrogating her? So what the hell is going on?
Okay.
I need to go and find out for myself.
So, slight disclaimer playing this game, because I know I talk a lot in quite a few of the other streams that I do. But, during cutscenes and whatnot, I will be mostly keeping my trap shot. Because, you know, important story stuff. If you want to know something, I can tell you what I can. And I don't give a damn about it. Oh, God damn it. So there's that one. There's that one. System. What is that for? Unclaimed DLC items. Oh. Oh, yeah. I also did buy, like, the big collector's edition one, so it came with a lot of stuff. So, yes, I will be having things available at the beginning of the game that a lot of people probably wouldn't have in the normal one. Okay, so that is all of the DLC available at the moment. And I can't do anything else yet. Wait. Oh, geez, and I didn't realize it started me off with 100,000 gold. Not that that's actually a lot. Okay, here we go. Could go all the way back this way, but that's not the right way, so we're gonna go this way. Would you quit touching her, Nimrod?
So it wasn't a lie. The slightest touch is like being struck by lightning.
What are you doing?
So you're finally awake, huh?
What's going on here? What is she ever-
Mind your business. So even if you don't mean to hurt somebody, if they touch you, they get electrocuted, huh? It doesn't seem to be poison or magic. Is this the reason Balsef's soldiers were after you? For the last several days, Balsef's forces have been getting pretty restless. When we looked into it deeper, the word thorns came up over and over again. Now, we come across Miss Prickly herself.
Drop the attitude. Did you really think we wouldn't find out anything about you, Miss Shion Imeris? That's her name. Jeez. What? You didn't figure it out already? Yeah, that's right. This lady's got herself a surname, which means one thing. She's a Ren, our enemy.
Yeah, but she was being chased by Ren soldiers. So then, why?
That's exactly what we're trying to figure out. After all, aside from the clothes they wear, there's only one way to tell a Dan from a Ren. And that's whether their eyes light up or not. Ain't that right, Bright Eyes?
Big talk for someone who can't even use astral arts. Embedded.
Don't you call us embedded! Look, you see the stone your people embedded in me? There isn't one. Because we gouged them out the day we swore to rise up against your kind. Not to arrest until every last one of you is-
We Danans may not be capable of using astral arts, but it looks like those thorns of yours won't do you much good in escaping here either.
Still, inflicting pain on anyone who comes near you, that's one hell of an ability.
You're wrong. Some kind of great ability.
No. Fair enough. All I know is Balsef must have his eye on you for a damn good reason. And until we find out why.
An ambush!
They must have tracked us down. Evacuate his plant. Hurry! And bring the girl. She gives you any trouble, wave a spear in her face. Hey, Iron Mask! Sorry, but right now it's everyone for themselves.
What about you?
I'm going to welcome our guests. Don't go dying on me.
Come on, move.
And don't try anything funny.
Oh yeah, the girl who can touch you, who can literally, like, cause you immense pain, and you're gonna freaking decide, like, oh hey. Yeah, we're just gonna do that. Frickin' Nimrods.
What's
the got an apple gel. On the plus side, we can save whenever in this game. Which is freaking awesome. That's new also, I think. Nothing else. Just a sword. So... We have DLC stuff, we may as well abuse it.
Enemy attack!
An ambush. Rains are here. I have to find an exit and get the hell out of here.
Brad has arrest you and tried to make you rat anyone out. You have two options. You either break out or find a way to keep quiet. Permanently. Look around for treasure.
Have these kinds of battles been going on this entire time? I just didn't know.
I mean, yeah?
Stop right there! Oh, it's just a Dennis. You there! Where's the redhead girl who was here?
Well,
spit it out! I want an answer, insurgent!
How's this for an answer?
Go to hell! You dare address a red armored soldier that way? I'll show you in bedding!
But I'm not in bedding. Triangle square. For X. R1 to attack. Circle to dodge, or R2 to dodge. Jeez. R2 to dodge.
Talk or die!
So much for playing nice. Alright, we're up! Now we are flying still. I have to do this.
I won't jump quietly!
God, I'm gonna have to reteach myself how to even play this game.
I actually beat one of those Ren soldiers. I gotta keep going. I have to survive this no matter what.
Yep, and to survive it, we have to do lots of looting and scavenging. Hey, Applejack.
An opponent like this should be easy.
Now you'll learn.
Okay, now I'm kind of remembering how to do stuff. Isn't there a lock-on, though? Like, a legitimate lock-on? L2 to switch, L1 to target. Okay, so if I hold L1, I think it locks onto a particular enemy.
What the? You got some kind of death wish? together. Besides, I don't much feel like being indebted to a Janet.
Fuck, suit yourself.
Combos! Yes, I know. Well, I kinda know.
What?
Okay, so there's that.
I call my own shot. Just stay out of my way and we'll get along quite well.
Kinda new for me, if you hadn't noticed. Don't expect any promises.
Danon like you possibly gain from helping a Renan like me?
Trust me, I've no great love for Renans. Guess I'm just not as consumed with hatred as some.
What?
Have we met somewhere before?
Me? Friends with a Danon? Can't say I've had the pleasure.
Well, when you put it like that, yeah, silly question. I don't remember anything about my past. Don't have any clues to go on either. Not even my own face.
Let me get this straight. You don't know what you look like, but you thought I might somehow recognize you?
Something like that. Guess my helping you back there wasn't as self-sacrificing as I made it out to be. Besides, I can't feel pain anyway. So it's not like...
Wait, you really can't feel pain?
Yeah. It's just another thing I don't have. No pain, no face. No memories. I only know one thing about myself. That's that I'm a slave.
What about your name? You must have one, right?
Iron Mask. Got the name from the person who found me. Said that this way I wouldn't forget I had a real name out there somewhere.
I see.
So where to next?
Outside, silly. What do you think we fought all this way for?
I do enjoy the comic book style skit stuff this time around. Like, it's a little more...
Can you even see out of that thing? Like, at all?
Of course I can. How else do you think I manage to avoid tripping everywhere I go?
What is that thing, anyway? It doesn't look like anything Dan and I've ever seen.
It's me. I don't remember anything about my past. When I came to, I was already wearing it. If I could get it off, I would. Damn thing makes it hard to eat. I can't scratch my face when it itches. It's the worst.
Honestly, I'm just impressed you managed to survive this long looking like that. I'm sure you attract attention wherever you go.
Most of the other Danons don't pay it any mind. It's in everyone's best interest to just keep their heads down, focus on their work, and pretend they don't notice.
What about the Renan soldiers? Didn't they notice?
Oh yeah.
The guards? They're more the kill first, ask questions later type. Be in the wrong place or step out of line and you're dead. Mask or no mask. That said, as long as you keep your head down and don't cause trouble, they mostly ignore you. Honestly, sometimes they don't look all that keen to stir up trouble themselves. A friend of mine said it's because if they kill us without a good reason, it could delay the work and put them behind schedule. At that point, it'd be their necks on the line. You should know more about all that than me, though, right?
I don't serve any of the lords. But I see what you mean. After 3 centuries of running rule without much upheaval, it's possible the soldiers may be losing their edge. All this trouble we've caused might be the first excitement they've had in a while.
Well, I don't plan on getting killed for their amusement.
Oh hey, she is officially in the party. Oh, nope, she is not apparently. Okay, now I do have some of the better stuff as well. Plasma shock, and then I only have Mirage for midair styles at the moment.
Glad to see you made it. I heard you managed to escape, but I didn't expect to see old Iron Mask with you. In any case, we're all wanted by the Renans. It'll be easier for everyone if you both just come with me.
Where are the others?
They're waiting for us up ahead. Come on.
Oh, damn.
Stay where you are, dissidents.
Just look at all these soldiers. How badly they want to destroy this hideout.
Apprehend the traitor! Slaughter the wreck!
Within her all along. No matter. Kill her if you have to. Just retrieve the core. Buster!
Okay.
Your arms.
Oh, yeah. How about that? Guess it's just as well I can't feel it, huh?
You're not in agony? Wait, are you serious?
Hold still.
Huh?
It's one of my healing arts.
Holy shit.
A sword that sears the hand of he who wields it, and a healing art to mend. A man numb to pain, and a woman whose very touch heals nothing but.
Thank you.
All right, let's rout the bastards and finish them off before the surviving stragglers have a chance to regroup. Iron Mask, you coming?
Definitely. I'm not about to go back all that way alone.
So I guess you're not planning on releasing me, huh?
Sorry. You're coming with us.
In that case, there's one thing you should know. No one uses that flaming sword without my say-so.
You needn't worry on that score. I doubt many of us could get close to it in the first place. Or would want to.
The blazing sword. It just might be strong enough to match the power of a lord. No, maybe even to surpass it.
Are you sure you're okay?
What do you mean?
Your wound. That soldier nailed you pretty good. Not to mention those flames bursting from you.
They only hit my master core, so I'll be fine. And the flames weren't even hot. It's probably because they're just a manifestation of the astral energy. Honestly, I'm more surprised that you really are incapable of feeling pain.
Did you think I was faking?
No, I believed you. I guess seeing you stay calm while bearing those burns to your hands just really made it hit home for me. It's ironic. I have no problem hurting anyone who touches me. But as soon as I try to wield that sword, it's me who gets hurt.
Do you wish you were impervious to pain too? You realize you could burn your fingers off without even noticing, right?
Says the guy who almost just...
So what? All I need right now is power. And up until now, I haven't come across anything stronger than that blazing sword the whole time I've been doing this.
You really don't care what happens to you as long as you get what you're after, do you?
Don't talk like you know me.
You're right. I don't get you. I don't get why you're so quick to throw it all away. Not when us slaves have never had a choice in whether we lived or died.
You befriended Chiyo. The friends teamed up with your party. Cheer points. Because, hey, we can't let people just infinitely heal. Because they're jerks like that. Not... I know it's not the most powerful one, but we're going to switch over to these other weapons, because I didn't use those the first time through this. Does that mean I have different outfit stuff that I missed beforehand? I mean, we're not going to do any of the new outfits right now. Largely due to the fact that we only have we can't see our character's face yet. There we go, that's what I was trying to say. Renan Armored Soldier. Elite Renan Soldier. Blah. If I want to try reading those, I'm going to have to read really fast. Super fast. Land of Brimstone and Swirling Ash, Orbis Calaglia.
That's
Glenamine Castle, stronghold of Lord Balseth, self-imposed ruler of all Calaglia.
I've never seen it from this close before.
That's it, all right. But next to it are the Gates of Fire. Take a good long look while you still can. That wall is what we've come to tear down. The only thing standing between us and freedom.
Kinda.
Freedom.
Let's go. Be careful. If you get close to a Zubu, they'll attack.
Bring it. Changing controls, don't care. Got to. I could swear there used to be a lock on where, like. Hang on. We're gonna freaking go look at the settings again. Like, you could lock onto an enemy and it would actually track where that enemy was. There we go. Yes, that is most definitely what I want. Honestly, either of those is definitely what I want. Wish to apply these changes? Yes, let's try that.
Don't fight any enemies you can otherwise avoid, alright?
Makes sense. If we try to take them all on, there'll be no end in sight.
Nope. We're fighting.
Normally I don't pick on the weak.
Oof. That's what I get for fighting something. For fighting something that they tell me to not fight. But, hey, would you look at that? Mining stuff.
What a weird stone.
I sense a strange power from it. We should gather as many as we can find.
Yep. Don't worry, we will be doing that often. Life bottles.
Seems you found something good. Supplies like that are valuable. Never overlook them.
Got it. I'll remember that.
Let's stop a moment to catch our breath.
I barely worked up a sweat.
Speak for yourself. What do you want, a medal? Doesn't look like we're being followed. Fail to grab these rare moments of quiet when you can. You'll end up regretting it later.
Yeah, boss.
I do love the campfire scenes. Camping out. Resting at a campground will restore your party's HP and CP. While resting, you can watch skits and cutscenes that you've previously viewed.
Normally, we should take turns standing guard. But this first time, I'll watch over things so you two can rest easy.
I never just sat and watched a fire like this before. It's surprisingly soothing.
Well, aren't you getting comfortable? You realize there are still Zoogles prowling around out here, right?
Ah, don't be a spoilsport. It's important to let your mind and spirit relax. It does you a lot more good than you might think.
Exactly.
Zephyr, why aren't you concerned about who I am?
You feeling left out, son?
No, it's not that. But
you said you wanted to fight so that you can live a free man. At this point, that's all that matters. Even if it somehow turned out you were a Renan, it wouldn't be such a big deal.
A Renan?
Until we know who you are, we can't rule anything out. Besides, we've already got Shion with us. At this point, what's one more Renan as long as they're on our side?
So you don't see every Renan as an enemy?
Our goal isn't to hunt down and kill all Renans. We only arm ourselves as much as we need to set ourselves free. If you can believe it, not every Danan agrees with what we're doing either.
Are you saying we have enemies among the Danans?
Not quite. They're just not up for rebelling, per se. The thing you have to remember is that everyone has their own path to walk.
I'm not sure I understand.
That's okay. Just focus on what we have to do right now. However, the time will come when you'll need to decide what to do for yourself.
How come you don't have a scar on your hand?
A scar? What do you mean?
The Crimson Crows all tore off their own spirit cores, right? But your hand doesn't show any signs of ever having a core like theirs. Why not?
I don't know. I don't remember anything about myself from before Doc found me.
Seriously? You have that mask, you don't feel any pain, and you just happen to know how to fight with a sword? No way. You must remember something.
I'm not lying if that's what you think. Believe me, I wish I knew who the hell I am. But I don't. It's funny
soul searching while digging up rocks in a mine.
Still.
Are you saying you've told us everything about yourself?
Zephyr.
It's bad manners to pry when you've got plenty to hide yourself.
You're not gonna ask me about my past too?
Only when I think it's necessary. You're a real man of mystery, I'll admit. That said, I'm not one to dig around in someone's business just out of curiosity.
Ooh.
If you remember something and feel like sharing, you're free to do so. For now, I think that's good enough.
Right. Thank you.
Attaboy, Zephyr.
So, this whole you not feeling pain thing, is that for real?
Why would I lie about it? Why would you care anyway?
No, it's just, you know, I can't imagine what it's like, that's all.
As a slave, I'd say it has its advantages and disadvantages.
Oh?
On the upside, when Ren soldiers push me around, I hardly flinch. The downside's that I get injured without even noticing. Which means I could be knocking on death's door and not even realize it.
Really?
Sure. I may be numb to pain, but it doesn't make me immortal or anything. Still,
pain lets you know you're still alive.
If someone hadn't pointed it out to me. If not for my fellow slaves, I'd be long dead, lying in a ditch somewhere.
Okay. Looks like we got all of the skits out of the way. We shall just rest.
A master core, huh? Now I see. So that's why Balsa's cronies were so desperate to catch her.
Is that what it's called? The jewel in her chest?
Oh, right. You don't remember a damn thing, do you? Fair enough. Guess it's time to fill you back in. Tell me, you ever wonder why we Danis are made to work ourselves to the bone, day in, day out?
Well, when you put it like that, I always just assumed we were mining resources for them.
And don't you think it'd be quicker if they used all that high-powered tech they have? Why go to all the trouble of relying on weak human labor? Listen, what the Renans are really after isn't resources or minerals.
I mean,
it's astral energy,
which is a resource.
They're harvesting the astral energy that sleeps inside all matter and life forms. And they're doing it the same way they have for the past 300 years, using us Danis as mere siphons.
Right. They have machines for minerals, but extracting from Danis requires spirit cores. Any astral energy collected passes through a spirit vessel on its way to being stored in a master core.
But why go to the trouble of collecting all this energy in the first place? Do they really need all that juice just to use astral arts?
It determines the sovereign.
Sovereign? Is that the Renan ruler?
Exactly. Five lords, each doing whatever it takes to gather as much astral energy as they can and store it in their master cores. Whichever of them manages to accumulate the most power at the end of their contest is crowned the ruler of the Renan motherland. A new crown contest, as they call it, is held every decade or so.
So you see, the master cores are the receptacles in which the lords store their power, and we Danis are sacrificed so the Renans can choose their new ruler.
That's insane! You're telling me that's what our people have been dying for this whole time?
Relax, hero. You're not the only one who's bent out of shape about the whole thing. There are two things that I haven't been able to get my head around yet. What business would a Renan have stealing a Master Core? And what's the deal with that blazing sword?
I think the sword is a physical manifestation of the Master Core's astral energy. As for why it took the shape of a sword, well, I don't know any more than you do. Honest.
And that stuff about needing your permission to use it? What was that about?
I'm the only one of us who can control the Master Core to some extent. Without me to adjust the flow of astral energy, The sword can't take a physical form.
What do you want out of this? You may be one of them, but you don't strike me as the ruthless oppressor type.
I'm going to take down all of the lords.
Never thought I'd say this, but I like the cut of your jib, Renan. Very well. As far as we're concerned, the struggle continues either way. And with that sword on our side, our chances of victory just increased. That is, of course, assuming we can count the two of you in.
Fine by me. After all, it sounds like we're after the same thing anyway.
I... honestly, I'm still a little confused by all this. But if it's a choice between this or going back to being a slave, then I choose to fight.
Then it's settled. Together we'll overthrow the Renan Lords. The first up on that chopping block is Balsef, the wild beast. Sound good?
Oh yeah. It's been a long time since I actually sat down and played this game.
We have another secret hideout in Ulzebek, not far from here. We should be able to meet up with our comrades there.
It's like I'm seeing a lot of this stuff for the first time again.
I hate camping out.
Well, Shion, you're gonna have to get used to it. Because we do a lot of it.
Hey, you find them, make sure to grab it.
It's edible, huh? Good to know.
Definitely. Cut it out. Didn't anyone ever tell you it's rude to stare?
I know I already asked you this, but are you sure we haven't met someone before?
What's so hard to understand? I'm Renan, you're Danon. There's no way. Besides, I'm from Lenegas. Trust me, wherever you were before you lost your memory, we've never crossed paths.
Lenegas? You mean the same Lenegas that's up in the sky? I've heard it called the Renan's Castle, but I never imagined people actually lived up there.
Well then, where did you think we all lived? Didn't you see the Renan Lords descend for the crown contest?
And how long ago was that?
Well, the current contest started 7 years ago, so...
Then I wouldn't remember.
Just how far back do you remember?
About a year, give or take. That's how long ago Doc found me.
1 year. Then no. I'm sorry, but there really is no way we could have met.
Guess not.
That's what you say now! I actually don't know the answer to that particular question, so... Ooh, there. Couldn't think. Climb faster. It's a good idea to check every nook and cranny. Because I do remember we have to try to find owls.
That's one enormous stray.
I don't think we can take it right now.
Yeah. I do remember that from my first partway playthrough. We're not even going to waste our time attempting it.
We've almost made it to Ulzebek.
Yep, going away. Come here, beasties.
Normally, I don't pick on the weak.
Still managed to actually hit. We found an orange gem. It will give us magic back. Nothing else in particular down here. So now we'll jump up here. That way we can fight the other beasties. Hey, I see you, Owl.
Woohoo! Woohoo! Woohoo!
That's right, Owl.
It's an owl. They're often used as a symbol to represent ancient Diana.
And we must find all of the owls. I do remember that particular sound. See you, beasties. I can't use the healing art. Yeah, we need to kill the little ones though so that we can be better prepared for them. Speaking of which, okay, she does have the slightly better rifle equipped. Ulzebek.
Okay, people, this is it. Ulzebek.
No sign of any Renin guardsmen.
The Renins are as populous as the Danins. Probably figure stationing guards in a place like this would be a waste of precious manpower.
So this is where the next safe house is?
Yes. The last place they think to look for enemies is on their own doorstep.
That is, assuming anyone actually made it here before us.
Zephyr!
Hey, would you look at that?
Looks like we needn't have worried.
Way to go, Shion. Now you sound like a jerk. Going to the inn.
Looks like we get to sleep with a roof over our heads.
Yay! Okay, weapons and stuff like that can't happen yet. We're fine. We don't need any more stuff. Sup, jerk. We're still not a huge fan of him. These two aren't bad, though. I kind of like them.
Zephyr, you made it! See? I told you there's no way Zephyr would have kicked the bucket.
Fine, you were right. So, what's the plan?
Well, we've got an ace up our sleeve, and the enemy's in disarray. I say we strike while the iron's hot.
So we're finally going head-to-head with Balsef.
That's right. We can't afford to mess this up. It's now or never.
Then now it is. We've all been waiting for this day for far too long.
Leave the plan to me. In the meantime... Yeah, you two need to do something about your outfits.
I have just the thing for your size. Stay right there, okay? Ta-da! I told you, it fits like a dream. I'm afraid we don't have any Renan clothing. I could find you some Danon outfits. But something tells me you'd rather pass.
Is this really that important?
In case you need reminding, I'm here because our interests overlapped. Nothing more. At no point did I say I'd given up being a Renan. Now, let's play nice. How about you ask Nate and see what he says? He's our one-stop shop for info around here. With any luck, he might just know something.
Yay, ocean blue battle garb.
Try to be careful not to stand out too much. You're the only Renan around here, you know.
I know. I was just thinking about how communal it feels here, even though it's only supposed to be slave quarters.
Huh? Oh, yeah. When you put it like that, I guess it is different from heavily patrolled Mosgul. Were you expecting something more depressing?
It's likely a sign that Balsef doesn't think you guys can do anything to him.
What?
I mean, if Balsef thought the Crimson Crows actually posed a threat to him, he'd figure he'd be trying harder to suppress them.
No. You're probably right about that. All of the other Danons that aren't with the Crimson Crows accept the Renan's rule as simply a fact of life. From the day we're born, no, probably even before that, it's been drilled into us that the only purpose our lives have is to help select the next sovereign.
If they don't like the status quo, then they should fight it. Otherwise, they're endorsing it either way.
I see it differently, but that's just me. Speaking of Renans, do all of them think about things the way you do?
I won't deny that among my fellow Renans, power and status are everything. However, that isn't what this is about for me. I have something I need to do, and I'll do whatever it takes, and use whoever and whatever I need in order to get the job done. To hell with power.
Wait. I heard it. Where is it? Where are you, you little shit? Are you up the ladder?
Here too.
generales.
Something new there.
Should this really be here?
An apple gel in the middle of the well? Well, I mean, not wrong?
Nate, we need your help.
Nah, damn. Never the manpower when you... Huh? Help, huh? What kind? Is it urgent?
Well, no, not exactly.
Well, in that case, would you mind helping me out with something first? The work's really piled up around here.
What is it you'd like us to do?
Anything you can manage. No one cares about us slaves. That's why it's all the more important that we stick together and take care of each other.
Exactly.
Check in with that guy over there for details on what he's doing. And thanks in advance.
I wonder if something happened.
Nate sends us. He heard you might be a little short-handed. You could say that. Didn't think he'd send over the Iron Mask himself, though. That a Brad Eyes with you? Sure, we can really trust her. She's on our side, Zephyr can vouch for her. Zephyr's good with her, I guess we don't have a problem. Ah, what the hell? But the name's Dire. I'm the one who runs this lodge. This is a lodge? But we all already have our own beds. We don't sleep on straw and rock-hard dirt around here. Crimson Groves have had their fair share of folks who are either knocking on death's door or can't otherwise move around openly. That's what this place is here for, to give people a place to rest up properly before they head off to fight. Everybody needs their rest, and if you don't rest, you can't hope to fight the Bright Eyes at your best. Makes sense. What do you want us to do then? I need you to help haul some cargo. I have some friends who are on their way to collect it from our hideout at the Zeon Mine. The mines? Is that really such a good idea after the Renin snuffed the place out? These are valuable items. People risk their lives together. We need to get at least some of them back. They should be down around the Sedinus Ravine at this point. Meet up with them and help them bring the supplies back to the lodge. You want to use the feast facilities if you need to. I'll let you sleep here for free. Sub quests.
I had no idea the Crimson Crows were so active.
You sound pretty thrilled by that.
Thrilled? Maybe. But I'll settle for hopeful. We know now that not everyone is rolling over for the rats.
Okay, so... Field Guide. Artifacts. Oh god. I have all sorts of different stuff. Activity records. Supply procurement. There we go. Send in this room. I see you, beasties. Forgot how some. Alright, we're actually going to do this. Here, you guys are going to use the most powerful shit that I can get my hands on.
Out of our way!
Here I come!
Yeah.
Take it!
8 mushrooms. Yeah, rocks. Mining ore stuff.
That's one enormous tray.
I don't think we can take it right now.
Yeah, no, I know we can't. Don't worry, we're not going to try to. Jeez. Always a good idea to fight stuff. Moving on. Just gonna keep on and run.
What? They're all dead? How did this happen?
Soldiers, that's how.
Are you Iron Mask?
Yeah, I am. Dairon sent me to help.
Hang in there. I'm so glad you made it. In the bushes over there. You'll
hang on.
Damn.
See, I'll do something.
That's no use. He's already dead.
Damn them. They've killed so many of us, and it's still not enough. They won't be satisfied until they've wiped us all out like pests.
He mentioned something about those bushes. We should check that.
Is this a cooking pot? But what is it doing here?
If I had to guess, he put it there to make sure Renan wouldn't steal it.
So even though he knew he was dying, he chose to use the last of his strength to hide it, believing someone would come for it. I guess you think it's stupid getting killed over a silly trinket, huh?
No. Clearly he risked his life for something he believed in. I would never mock someone for that. However, it will be up to us to figure out the purpose behind his dying act.
We'll make sure it wasn't in vain. If nothing else, this proves that the Lennons can be outsmarted. We'll carry out your
work. I also don't think they would be that concerned about a cooking pot.
We don't know when those soldiers might be back to make another sweep of the area.
So this is what it means to fight the Lennons.
Sounds like you're kind of scared to me.
Of course I am. If I'm going to die one way or another, I'd rather go down fighting.
I hate camping out.
Yes, Shion, we know. We know you don't like it. Quick. Oh, wait, that reminds me. I didn't want to switch that other setting around again. Reposition to throw a target when moving a character. We definitely want strong and strong. Camera speed, field, camera speed, battle. And then now, the default is good for that. Okay, that's basically everything. I can definitely live with the zoomed out camera. I like it better when it when it's zoomed out a little bit. Wish it was like that more often, but oh well. What can you do? Am I right? Alright, Darren. Damn, so nobody made it, huh? I'm sorry. If we'd arrived just a little sooner, we could have. Hey, these things happen. It hurts, but this is the world we live in. Take good care of what you brought back. It's the only way we can respect the sacrifice of those we lost. Hey! When's Daddy coming home? Oh no. That's the guy's kid.
Aww.
Not yet, sweetie. Not yet, sweetie. Your dad's gone away for a while, and... Don't lie to me. He's dead, isn't he? I know that whenever grown-ups look sad and say someone's gone, they always mean they're dead. Daddy always warned me that this might happen one day. He told me to stay strong and to be brave. So, I. This isn't right. Poor kid shouldn't have been dragged into our mess. Let's report back to Nathan, then get ready to fight. Hey! Side quests. Emblem obtained. Sorts of stuff. Titles. As you fulfill certain requirements for each of your characters, you'll earn titles for them, which can unlock arts and skills that they can then learn, making fights easier. You can view title unlock requirements from the skill panel. Skill panel. Yeah. Basically, it's the grid sphere from FF10, but not as complicated. Let's see here. We definitely want Sonic Thrust. And Slippery Wind. And Stardust. And then all three of those already have the thing. Yes. Yes. Increased midair damage. Increased critical damage. Midair evasion. Increased max AG. That is definitely something that is worth prioritizing. Honestly, may as well master out some of these since we've got the points to do it. There we go. Arts. thrust, severing wind. There we go. I know you can level certain stuff up as you're going as well. Nath is up there, but it looks like there's another quest thing.
You see anybody around here who could use our help?
We can't chase after every little thing.
Yes, we can.
I'm skeptical.
Is Zugel still out there? Big guy. It's like insect wings. Right. Arms. Yeah, we saw him. Pretty big and tough. It's hard to feel safe knowing it's still out there. I'd really like to see it get its comeuppance one of these days, especially since the people that deliver comeuppance are going to enjoy a pretty mighty payday on account of all the materials. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yep, Zugel materials are imbued with astral energy. So the stronger they are, the more energy their materials contain. We could use them to make new weapons and stand up to Rena a little better, even with our astral art handicap. With the Audstray, I could usually gather a few people and get the materials myself. But something that big is bound to be beyond my capabilities, if only there was a good way to beat it. We'll take it on. I don't see the harm in us checking it out. Do you hear what you're saying? We've got enough to worry about without... as it is without inviting even more danger. Your enemy pal is right. I know you're strong, but I think even this Zugel might be beyond you. It's not like I need you guys to take it down first right away, but how should I put it? If anybody has a shot at it, I think it's still you guys beat. Or I think it'll still be you guys eventually. Once you feel like you're up to the challenge, that is. When you are, would you be willing to give it a shot? You can bring other people along with you to help.
Got it.
Sure, sounds fair. We'll get it taken care of for you sooner or later. Hey. I don't remember what level that thing is at. I see no other envelopes. Oh, Nath.
You're back, huh? Sounds like it was a real ordeal out there. Much as I hate to admit it, there aren't many of us who can take on those Renan armored soldiers. All we can do is make sure we remember those who sacrificed their lives for the cause. Yeah, they won't be forgotten. Glad to hear it. Now, what was that favor you wanted to ask me? Oh, right. Well, you see... So then, you're wondering if I know of any places where you can find Renan equipment, huh? Anywhere with those damn bright eyes is gonna have tight security, of course. Can't just go carelessly poking around. Unless... Across the wilderness, outside Ulzebek, you'll find the Fagin ruins. There's some kind of old Renan castle out there. What with it being impenetrable, I forgot. But with a Renan tagging along, who knows? Maybe you can find some way in.
Hey.
Though, it's a lot of trouble for some Renan rags. If I were you, I'd get comfortable with Dannon guards.
Those look like they're ruins. Let's move.
Are we really going in there?
Yes. Now let's move.
She's dead set, dude. Just don't argue with her.
Hey, Sheila. Where does your gun come from?
What do you mean, where does it come from?
When you're fighting, it looks like it just appears out of nowhere.
Oh, that's transferal technology. When I don't need my weapon, I submerge it in empty space. And when I do, I summon it. Make sense?
Not really, but it sounds pretty amazing.
Huh?
Well, that way you don't have to carry around any heavy weapons or worry about enemies trying to steal them, right? It's a pretty cool invention.
You realize you're praising the technology of your enemies, right?
So? Technology is technology. It's not good or bad in and of itself.
I guess that's true.
I really love Iron Mask. I know his actual name, but we refer to him as Iron Masks to avoid spoiler type stuff. But he is a main character. Like, he is such a practical main character so far. And I love it. I love the practicality in using, like, logic. Like, there's been lots of times where he's, like, wanted to blow up and get mad about something.
You're not really doing this.
And then he holds.
There are Sookles here, too?
Hang on.
Hey!
You should always assume there's Sookles anywhere you go. They're one of the reasons I need you all. We're a team, after all. That means you need to pull your weight. So when I call for you, I expect you to clear out any enemies around. What? Why do I have to do all the... In exchange, when you call for me, I promise I'll shoot down any enemies around you, too. Sound fair?
Right.
Yeah, alright. If you don't get in the habit of speaking up during fights, that'll impact morale and our ability to combo together. So make sure you do it often. Got it.
Just a minute.
Looks like the enemy spotted us. Time to get to work. You don't have to tell me that. Boost attacks. Iron Blade initiates a brute force wing.
With that blade in your strength, the average noodle shouldn't be a problem, right?
Now give it a shot. You picked the wrong fight.
And now we gotta do
Shions.
I'll shoot them down. I never miss.
Blah, 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 blah.
Here I go. It's over.
This one.
A swallow blade. Rising water.
A freezing storm.
And blast away again, Shion. There we go.
This was all mine. No escape. You picked the wrong fight.
Where are you going?
You were handy in a pinch.
It's like a true mutton to you.
Well, can't be anyone better.
He's like, you got the hang of it, but don't let it go to your head. Those were easy ones. I know. Don't worry, that is what we are going to do. We are also going to do all sorts of foraging and find hidden treasures. Okay, treasure chest. Would you look at that? 500 gold. More foraging.
Out of our way.
Take it. Come and face me. Stop. Rising water. Shoot us. Here I come.
Hey. I'm kind of remembering some of my better combos. Click, click. Really want to make sure we don't.
You're finished! Rising Wyvern! Scooter!
None shall escape my
There we go.
Let's keep our eyes on the prize.
And then down here, we have more potatoes. Potatoes. Boil them, mash them, cook them in the stew. Okay, or go that way. There is something in the house. Mushrooms. In this house, we found an apple gel. Zoom in as much as we can, please. Okay, so we've kind of looked over everything up yonder this direction. So now we just go further into stuff. Like, hello, bees! Nicely done.
Together, that wasn't even a problem.
Well, let's do this one. Another treasure bag. Maybe some zoogles. Potatoes!
Get lost! Hey. A freezing storm! I tornado!
Rising wiper!
Let the marksman handle this! This one's mine!
Take
it! Healing arc. Damn!
Healing. Now investigated all of that. Found potatoes. So now we can come around this way. Run past them because we're gonna fight them all the way back here. Found more wheat.
No choice. I'll take you all on. Blade.
Fire of fury.
Rising water.
Jill. No other shinies. The shinies. What's up here? I see you, owl. Yeah, there's a stupid amount of owls. And then we can't go in here. These zoogles.
I won't forgive you!
Bam!
Together, that wasn't even a problem.
Now we got the chunks. Okay. Fishes. Now nah, take the things.
Get lost!
You're mine! It's over!
Stay on instant!
Woo!
Mega Ray! Jedi Alpha!
You're mine! Come on! Splash!
A freezing storm!
Rising Wyvern! Shut up!
If I remember correctly, the last time I was going through this, I just ended up using the same art over and over and over again until I, like, got it to the next start up. But we'll just experiment every time we learn new ones. Find out combos that work. More potatoes.
An opponent like this should be easy. Don't take your eyes off the prize.
I'm quite aware without you reminding me.
Here I come. You're finished. Come on.
There we go. Yeah, marksman. Right. Right,
Jim. That's what I like to hear.
What do we have over here? Oh, look. We found lavender. Stat boosting herbs, which I don't really use until, like, right before the end of the game. Or if I come across a solo part that...
Get lost! By the power of water, this one's mine! By the power of water!
You picked the wrong fight!
Next!
Let's keep our eyes on the prize.
Okay, so we investigated that. There's a water thing over there. And just right around here is the only... stuff I've really got to check out still. There is a lot of exploration in this game. Well, kind of. I mean, there's just a lot of nooks and crannies that need to be invested and engaged in.
I wonder if those are the Fagin ruins below us. Shouldn't be too much farther now if that's the...
Yeah.
I guess it's been a while since I had a bite to eat.
It is a big deal. You should eat whenever you can. The last thing I need is you keeling over in the middle of a fight just because you didn't eat.
Never thought I'd get lectured on eating by a Renan, of all people.
Yeah, well, some of us Renans know what it's like to go without food, believe it or not.
What do you mean? I thought...
This isn't about me. Now, are you going to eat or not?
I would, if we had anything to eat. But we don't.
Actually, I have a little bit of food on me.
You've been carrying that stuff around this whole time? Not sure it's going to be enough for the both of us, though.
That's why we're going to cook it instead.
Yay!
Cook? I've never done anything like that before.
Me neither, to be honest. But we've got to make something out of all this, so might as well try.
Famous last words.
Your clothes are all about function over form. You should think about sprucing them up a little.
Why? What purpose would it serve?
I guess you're right. I just think you'd look good with a little blue thrown in somewhere.
All right, I'll think about it.
And so we get the first real chunk of Shion's personality. She likes fashion. Attack up, defensive. Consume double ingredients for plus 90% to cooking. I don't want to use the Mapo Curry Bun too much. And then I only have one of that, and I only have one egg. I only got the one strawberry and one that, so I guess we'll go ahead and eat the porridge for now.
All done. Come and eat. You really do eat through that mask of yours, huh? I'm impressed you can manage so well.
Huh? Oh, it's nothing. Get used to it after a while. Still, I'm glad we decided to stop and fill our stomachs. I've got a newfound respect for cooking now. But I guess that's easy when you're used to eating everything raw. It would have been perfect if it had any flavor.
Sorry it didn't live up to your palate.
Oh, no, that wasn't a knock on you. I was just... Sorry. That's not how I should thank you for cooking for me.
God, he's such a good guy.
Is it just pain you can't sense, or are your taste buds shot too?
Oh, sure, my taste buds work fine. Although, apparently, what I like tends to be a little out there.
How so? What's so unusual about what you eat?
Well, one time I couldn't get enough of these things I picked off a plant, but everyone else said they were way too spicy. Doc thinks maybe I crave spicy food to compensate for the lack of pain I feel.
Maybe it's best I take charge of the cooking. You know, just to be honest with that. I can't guarantee it'll be to your tastes, though.
I said I'm sorry. Look, I'll learn to tone down my tastes in the future, so let's just put that slip of the tongue behind us already.
Let's see here. This is Speedy Chef. There we go. Zoom in. Let's go ahead and just have her master this one. Ta-da! Because all of this stuff is stupid expensive. Off we go. System save. And let's continue.
This must be it. Looks pretty ancient, but I recognize red and architecture when I see it.
I've seen some beings. If it stayed sealed all this time, it's not because people left it alone.
It's not just their technology. The Renans build their structures out of special materials, too. Strong enough to withstand assaults from Danon tools and weaponry, anyway.
So, how the hell are we?
Because we have a Renan with us.
Easy.
Of course, like... all this does is provide us with an amazing possibility of, like, hey, we get to go investigate a bunch of Renan stuff.
I can't just walk in.
Mutual.
That may not have been a fancy feast we just had, but I don't remember the last time I felt this full.
Do the Renans often not give you all enough to eat?
It's never enough. The Renans decide exactly how much we'll have and when we'll have it. And that's that. We do our best to get around it. Everyone has to grow their own food and such behind the Renans' backs in order to get by. Thinking about it now, I wonder if they've always kept it meager so we wouldn't ever have the energy to try to resist what they've done to us.
Yeah. An empty stomach takes its toll on the body and the spirit after a while.
How does a Renan like you know what it's like?
I may be Renan, but they don't like me either. I could be squeaky clean and they still wouldn't give me anything.
Did your stomach just...
I didn't hear anything.
But you just ate. How are you already...
I said I didn't hear anything.
I still have some I haven't eaten yet. Do you want it?
Sure.
Ah, bonding over food.
Looks
it's the greatest of things.
It used to be a supply base of some sort. It probably even dates back to the Great Conquest of 3 centuries ago.
For an abandoned place, sure is crawling with critters. Kinda makes you wonder how they all got in.
But a point like this should be easy.
Treasure chest.
Is this a chest of some sort?
A random kind, yeah. We should definitely hold on to what's inside.
There's no such thing as too many life bombs. Always a good thing to remember. Well, actually, no, there actually is. The thing is, not too many. But that's just because this game is mean and limits the amount of items that you can carry. Well, and that's Tails games in general as well. Like, you can only carry a certain amount of items.
Hmm.
chest. More apple juice. Apple juice is good. Haha! See, this game is also fantastic, only because of the fact that you can jump gaps. I do like the byplay in battles, also. Let's say it gives characters a good chunk of personality. Which is wonderful. Like, you can never go wrong with characters having, you know, good personalities.
Ugh. There. We've been walking around for a while now. Up already?
Nope.
Tired?
Tired of something, all right.
I'm not giving up until we search every inch of this place.
She's really determined to find those clothes.
Yep. For good reason.
Get lost!
Slowly coming back to me. And look, an elevator. Yay, we turned off the thingy, which we can actually see the door from here, which means we can get to it. And if we jump off here,
what a rush!
Huh. Hello.
That equipment should come in handy.
Accessories. Pierce gives us penetration. We're gonna actually give that to Shield though. Thing crossed. Can't go. Yeah, I do go this way. Take us to the residential.
Is this Renan technology? I'm amazed you guys can pull something like this off.
For us, sites like this are completely normal.
Huh.
This must be...
the former owner's old wardrobe. Yeah.
I wonder how long they've hung here. They don't look like they've aged a day.
The designs are a little dated, but it'll have to do.
Listen, I get it. You care how you look. But we've got places to...
Iron Mask, I had to have a baba, huh?
What is it?
Well, Iron Mask?
No, I... We've kept Zephyr and the others waiting long enough. We should head back.
Okay, let's head back to Wolzebeck.
You're in a good mood. Were you that happy to find a new outfit?
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm the same as ever.
No, you're not. You are indeed very happy.
Let's keep our eyes on the prize.
You said before that this probably used to be a supply depot, right? Nay thought it was a Wren castle. I wonder what it actually is.
Who knows?
Who knows?
What, can't I not know something? You didn't think I knew every last thing about my own kind, did you?
I didn't say that.
From what I've heard, a lot of the materials that were initially brought over from Rena 300 years ago were repurposed for other things over time. So it's entirely possible that this place used to be both a supply depot and a lord's castle at different points in time. They're not mutually exclusive. I couldn't tell you when the lord's castle moved to its current location, though. Well, satisfied?
Yeah. Thank you. You know, for telling me about all that.
It's not like I mentioned anything that useful. Come on, let's keep moving.
He's also insanely inquisitive. Which characters... crap, hang on. I don't want to see that tip again. There's gotta be a button to see that. Field guide. Places, people, other. So that's all lore. Well, not lore. What kind of lore? Health. Art proficiency and awakening. Each character has 3 art proficiencies. These proficiencies go up as character uses arts of the corresponding type. Once a proficiency reaches a certain level, you can learn new arts by using an art of the same type during combat. Enhancing arts. Once you've used an art a certain number of times, as signified by count, a star will light up and will become stronger. Each art can be enhanced up to a total of 5 times. Alright, time to just start upgrading.
Rising Viper! Gerard! Pierce through! Now!
she's using the wrong rifle. Use your proto arm.
Yeah, we better. We don't have time to waste.
Someone's in a hurry.
Hey, look at that. We can fast travel, folks. And now that we have found all the stuff, we can actually, like, be like, oh, hey, I want that. So we can click on Ulzebek and then fast travel into Ulzebek. This is gonna make side quests way easier.
Always good to be back in familiar territory.
Hey, you're that Iron Mask Zephyr brought in, yeah? Can I ask you a small favor? Sure, what is it?
Yeah.
I appreciate you being so quick to help. Here's the deal, we're running short on food. Okay, granted it's something of an ongoing problem around here. Soil around here doesn't have much to offer and our crops are doing even worse than usual lately. I won't ask you to go fetch anything crazy, just some wheat and potatoes would help plenty. Hand over the food.
Huh?
That's exactly what I'm looking for. Oops, sorry. Sorry for the loud noise. You sure I can have it? As much as we need fresh food that grows out in the wild, I can't ask anyone to go with all the zookas running around. If you don't mind, I'll go ahead and help myself to what we've got. You're a big help. We couldn't exactly afford to risk tearing up the horse nest, producing the bright eyes cutting off. With all this extra food, now we can feed all the kiddos who have been going hungry. Glad to hear it. Just happy that I can help. Might not be able to see your face, but I can tell you're a good soul. I don't have much to offer you in return, but I can teach you a recipe that's really easy to prepare if you like. You're talking about the ones that use wheat. I already know that.
Okay,
in that case, how about a potato recipe? This one's also simple to fix and tastes good. You're a lifesaver.
Yes.
Hey!
Sorry for the side trip.
We got to learn a new dish. I'll take what I can get, really. Let's cook it next time we make camp.
Is that all she went along with this?
Yep. She wants food, man. Like, she's not that hard to figure out. If anything, it's amazing. Because you don't have to guess all the time. Just like, oh, hey, she wants food. She's apparently not even picky about food. Hey. Hey. I love the fact that you can do that too. How badly did that mess with my food supplies, though? Okay, plus, cool, I don't care less about all that. It's all that. Materials here. We have 44 wheat and potatoes. Potatoes. 28 potatoes. Okay, so we don't necessarily need to go like gather much more. And we will find more, so I'm not overly worried.
Crap!
Zephyr, we've got a huge problem. Something bigger than our attack on Balso's castle? Because I don't have any time to worry about anything else right. Yes, bigger than that. The Bright Eyes. They've started massacring folks all over Calagos.
What?
It must be after her Master Core. Guess the enemy must be serious about retrieving it. They must be if they're willing to kill slaves they need to harvest astral energy. Moscow got hit real bad.
Wait.
What? Are you sure about that? Positive. It's the closest town to where we were attacked, to where we attacked them earlier. I feel bad for our people there, but them's the breaks. Bastards. Really should have thought a little bit about that.
You know where. Moscow.
What good is it going to do to...
I don't need your permission.
Yep. First and foremost, we go this way. For now, we have things to explore. Hey, got pepper. So let's see if that actually, like... Hey, okay, so 50. And just... 100 gold. And scrap meat. School and then river's over here, which I don't even remember what it. Oh, Cave of Solitude.
Looks like this place opens out into the ocean.
The water's so much clearer than what's on the surface. I even see fish swimming around.
Yeah, and boy, do they look delicious.
What?
Never mind.
Can't go catch fish. At least not yet, anyways. Actually, I don't know if that's a thing or not. But these are fantastic little places to be able to get some stuff. So we made it all the way around to there, and then that kicks out by Moleskull. But now there's all that other area over there that we need to go investigate. love the fact that he, that this main character does the mid-air combo. Like, it's actually very fun. The mid-air fighting is very, very fun to use. Okay, can't take that right now. Okay, one path off to the left, and then there's all this stuff over there. And there's also a climbing point, apparently. There.
Let a marksman handle it. Barely a blip on our radar.
And there. Okay. Anything else up here? Nope. I can't get it to the next area. The watchtower.
I won't forgive you.
You're mine.
Fly in distance.
Rising wiper. Come on.
Looks like we won.
Okay, moving on. Fight the baddies over here.
Hey,
here are those mushrooms.
Try it and see how it turns out.
You just want to try new food. Not that I can blame you. New food is an amazingly novel experience. It should be done by all. Demon Fang! There's a classic.
Barely a blip on our radar.
Can't be a Tales protagonist without Demon Fang.
Just take it easy. It's all right now. Most were able to escape, and we've survived. Honestly, we got off lucky. It's often worse when a resistance group pops up.
Lucky? You call people getting slaughtered like this lucky?
This is how things go when you're a Dan slave. You're dead if you stand up to them. Keep your head down and do as you're told. You only have one life. That's why...
I should wait for the right moment?
Yes.
So someone else dies instead while we live another day. Is that what you're saying, Doc? You're willing to risk everything on the chance that things will get better if we wait long enough. But what's the point of waiting if others have to die so that we can live?
What do you think happens when someone tries to resist? It'd be one thing if the rebel died, and that was that. But it never ends with only one death.
Mm-hmm.
You've seen it for yourself. Everyone suffers for it. Knowing that, are you really going to tell me our waiting has no meaning?
But that's... I understand not wanting to throw away the same lives we're trying to protect. That would be senseless. But if you wait too long, if you get too used to waiting, eventually you lose the will to fight. I don't want that to happen to me. I've already met the Crimson Crows. People who risk their lives to fight the Renan's rule. People who know they might not live to see us win, but fight anyway to give those who come after a better chance. My life is at risk either way. And I'd rather spend it fighting.
So you've decided to take up the sword?
Yes. But not just any sword. It's a sword that only I can wield. But one that's also too powerful to use on my own. I doubt those who fought the Renans in the past ever had something like this on their side. That's why I'm willing to bet everything I have on this sword. I know it might mean more people end up in danger, but...
Okay. If that's how you feel, then forget what I said. It's clear your time has come, Iron Mask. Currently, you and that sword are the only things capable of driving the Renans back. It's because of you that we're sick. There's a way through this for all of us, then I'll put my trust in you to find it.
Doc, thank you.
Now, remember what you said, and don't ever abandon that conviction of yours, all right?
Right. I won't.
You've grown so much since we first met.
Mm-hmm.
And you've met some good people, too. Maybe you have a chance after all.
Well, thanks, Doc. What's up, Doc? The only thing we're checking is both of those guard towers, I think, which I can't even check. And nothing up this one anyways. Fight! Got it.
Let's keep our eyes on the prize. keep our eyes on the prize.
You're back. Hurry on in. We've been waiting for you.
You're not gonna ask what happened.
I can tell enough by the way you look right now.
I see. Zephyr, I need to ask you something. Would you have invited me to join you, even if I didn't?
Of course.
Why, though?
There aren't many folks out there who are crazy enough to resist their Lennons like we do. So when I find someone with a knack for it, I make sure to keep them close. Plus, you reminded me of another guy we lost. Maybe deep down, I'm trying to help you as a way of making amends for what I couldn't do for him. But if you don't want this, just say the word.
I'm not going anywhere. If it weren't for you, I wouldn't even be here.
If you say so. All right, come on in.
Thanks.
Aramis, can I have a minute of your time? Hey, Darren, what do you need? Well, all you've been doing since you got here is fight, right? I'm starting to get worried about how your weapons are holding up. After all, you're about to fight Balsef. You'll need to be prepared for whatever he might throw at you. Luckily, we happen to have a blacksmith here on site. You should see what he's got tempered. Alright, I'll make sure to remember that. Forging from scratch. Hey, guess what? There's a... there's a crafting system. Blacksmith dude, where are you? There he is.
Hey.
You the blacksmith here?
Yeah.
Yep, Darren filled me in. In addition to farm tools, I also make weapons for the Crimson Crows. Knowing it's for you, I just have to come. I'll forge you the best weapon I can manage with the materials I've got. Craft weapon. Can't really mess with that at the moment. But we can do a long sword. You want to craft it, yes. And then her basic rifle, I don't have anything for. So, what do you think about this? Not bad at all. That's the most you'll get out of me right now. Bring me more materials and I'll whip you up something grander. This is plenty enough grand as it is. I never knew Zuko parts were so versatile.
Good.
Thanks, glad to hear it. I'll leave the rest in your hands. Go give the Ren a helm and set us free, okay? That's the plan. Okay, really, there is no others.
Yeah, these ingenious structures and gadgets never cease to amaze me. Check out these handle grooves.
I'm not sure what I'm supposed to be seeing here.
So now we have Iron Mask, the birth of a weapon maniac. Side quest things. Nothing over there. We did find our owl. What's that green mark for again? Yeah, you. You're not the only new here. Here, you don't remember much at all, right? Well, if you got any questions, lay them out. I'll see what I can tell you. Never mind. I'm good, thanks. Alright, well, if you think of something you need to ask, just let me know.
Alright, everyone. It's time. Remember, eyes on the prize. We're after Balsif. Nothing else. Cut off the head, and the snake perishes. Hit them head on, however, and we won't make it through the chasm gates, let alone reach Balsif himself. Luckily, we have an ace up our sleeve. We need to do everything in our power to make sure that ace reaches Balsif's jugular. To that end, I'll be splitting us up into separate forces.
You just said all of us hitting them head on would be useless. Why would we divide ourselves up?
Because we're the decoys. We'll buy our ace in the hole the time they need to get in. We only need to cause enough of a ruckus around the castle to distract the enemy. That said, we need to look like the real deal, which is why I'll be tagging along too.
You too, Zephyr? So, who's going to take on Balsif?
The Iron Mask. I'm counting on you and Shion to make your way to wherever Balsif's hiding. Once there, you drive that flaming sword right through him.
You aren't seriously sending in just those two, are you? One of them's gonna win it.
No one said the plan was perfect. By far, the biggest danger is the one you two will be facing. The fate of this quest rests entirely in your hands, which is why you get the final say. You want out? Now's the time to say so.
And if we say no?
Then you say no. Just means we're back to square one, that's all.
And I go back to being a slave.
It's your life.
No, it isn't.
Ball's in your court, soldier. What do you say?
I want to fight.
But for what? What are you fighting for?
To free the Danites from the yoke of their abusive oppressors. To no longer die at the whim of another. To break the shackles of our enslavers. To live and taste freedom!
All while I have a big ass Iron Mask.
I believe we have our ace in the hole, people. Hold on to that belief, and we just might break through that wall yet. And what about you?
I was born ready. Now can we get this show on the road?
There's a gate on your right once you leave. Go through it and ride the elevator you find. I'll send ahead a few friendly faces to keep watch on your way. If you get into any trouble, look to them for support. We all clear? Good. May this battle herald the end of the Renan's bloody three-century reign. To your battle stations, everyone.
I still can't believe this is happening. We're really about to face off against a Renan lord.
Well, you're in pretty high spirits for a guy going into a life and death battle.
I'm not saying I'm not worried. But you have to remember, this is the first time any of us Danites have really had any hope.
Mm-hmm.
What about you? You scared at all?
I don't have time to be scared. This is only the first step in a long, long plan of mine.
You want to take down all five lords, right?
hard to believe it'll ever happen.
But it will.
I know. I haven't forgotten our deal.
See that you don't. That said, if we lose, we might suffer a fate worse than death, you know.
That's probably true. But instead of worrying about it, wouldn't it be a better use of our time to figure out ways to avoid that and not lose?
I suppose.
Whatever happens, I'll put everything I have into win. You can count on that.
Yeah. Alright there, ladies and gents, so I'm going to go ahead and call the stream there. So, we are diving into a new game for Modern Monday, and it's going to be Tales of Arise. And next week, we'll be diving into The Lair of Balseth, the Wild Beast. So, for a shilling slash refresher of the schedules, Friday, we have, Fantasy Friday, where we are still trying to make our way through Final Fantasy IV, the After Years. We are very close to the end, but it is a lot of bosses all in one go. So, I don't even know if I can guarantee that we'll beat it next Friday. But we will find out for sure. Like, I might even start early to try to give myself some more time to try to get it done. On Saturday, we have Strider Day, which is Fire Emblem Path of Radiance. At the moment, Strider Day is where I play strategy RPGs, like Fire Emblem and whatnot. We're doing good. We just became Lord Ike, which is funny because he's so against it. On Sunday, we managed to finally beat Alpha this last Sunday, so we dived into Mega Man Battle Network 4 Blue Moon, and we are going to continue that adventure, and then I'll be back on next Monday with more Tales of Arise from Modern Monday. Also, I have a YouTube channel. It is youtube.com/FlyingTBarC. If you enjoyed this or you want to watch any of my other playthroughs, go check that out, especially because Twitch is only going to keep videos for 7 days now, unless you are a Twitch Prime person, which I am currently not. So if you really want to keep up with any of my playthroughs, YouTube is the place to go. I start uploading videos on Tuesdays most of the time, and that is the best place to come and that is the best place to be able to watch an entire playthrough all the way from to the finish. Let's see here. I am going to attempt to see if there's anybody reading. Yes, we will raid D. Baba Ganoush, because it looks like he's actually playing Stranger of Paradise Final Fantasy Origin. So, that'll be a great little tie-in. And good night, everybody.